Every farmer fights the same battle. Produce a crop, but keep costs down. You know the challenges. Rising costs for fertilizer, fuel, and pesticides. Market prices that rise and fall. And unpredictable weather conditions. In the battle to remain financially viable, today many farmers are making a change. They're managing their farms with a key goal: to build healthy soil. These farmers are taking advantage of natural ecological processes to restore soil structure, cycle organic nutrients, and retain water in their fields. Building healthy, naturally functioning soil takes time and commitment, but the results are dramatic and will allow you to pass your farm on to the next generation. Let's take a look at the reasons why farmers have used conventional methods for tilling the soil. For centuries, farmers believed that soils needed to be loosened and mixed in order to distribute nutrients and create seed beds at planting time.
It was a way of a quick fix. When we would harrow the land, we would break the land. What we would do is just break down that soil quality and that organic matter and the carbon in the soil.
Anytime you disturb the soil in your fields, you pay a high price.
It takes a lot of energy to disturb the soil. It takes a huge amount of diesel to move the tillage equipment. It takes a lot of time.
Continuous traditional tillage exposes soil organic matter on the surface, where it's rapidly consumed by bacteria and lost to the environment as carbon dioxide. Conventionally tilled soil generally retains only 30 to 40% of the organic matter found in undisturbed soil. Conventional tillage also destroys soil structure. Soils without structure are vulnerable to wind and water erosion, and they're more likely to become compacted. Water has a harder time infiltrating the soil, and more water is lost to runoff and evaporation. In short, soil functionality declines. Intensive tillage forces you into an ongoing battle with weeds. Tillage exposes weed seeds on the surface and allows them to germinate. It also buries crop residues that naturally retard weed growth. All of these things threaten the long-term viability of your farm. Fuel, fertilizer, and other chemicals are expensive today, and they won't be getting any cheaper. Every year, more farmers make the decision to begin building healthy, naturally productive soils on their land. Very often, they choose to start gradually. The management changes you make to begin building healthy soil take patience, and every farm presents its own challenges. But the payoff is worth the effort. Let's take a look at what you'll gain by committing to a program of building healthy soil on your farm. Healthy soil does a better job of conserving water. Water is better able to infiltrate the soil, and the soil organic matter retains water during periods of drought. Surface residues help cut down on water lost through evaporation. When you reduce tillage, you also reduce the amount of time you're required to spend working your fields. And less time working your fields means less money spent on fuel. Healthy soils with a living plant cover and surface residue will make it easier to manage pest plants and organisms, and it will allow you to minimize your reliance on herbicides and pesticides. Healthy soil in farm fields can sharply reduce the amount of money you spend on fertilizer. This is because your nutrient efficiencies become much higher. Fewer nutrients are lost to the environment, and more of them reach your plants. Over time, many farmers are able to cut their nutrient inputs by 20 to 50%, sometimes by even more. This higher nutrient efficiency comes from higher levels of soil organic matter and larger numbers of soil organisms working to restore and recycle nutrients. In the upcoming parts of this series, we'll take a look at the science behind healthy soils, and then at practical ways to achieve your goals and help you pass your farm down to the next generation.